The next thing that I want to demonstrate for you is how to separate the picture from the frame by doing a bevel cut. I call this a self-framing plaque because the frame is actually part of the same piece of wood. And in order to make it the picture part sit back, we need to do a bevel cut angled along this edge here. We want the saw blade to angle out so the frame would come forward and the picture would go backwards. And most saws have tilting mechanisms of some way or another. I have an Excalibur saw, and instead of the table tilting like it does on most saws, the head actually tilts, and I'll show you how we do that. There's a little switch under here, a little lever, and we loosen that, and then you can dial it so the head can turn left or right. And in order to do a plaque approximately half inch thick, I like to go about 4 degrees. The deeper the bevel, the less amount the frame will sit back. So I don't want to go too deep. I'm going to just tilt it to 4 degrees, which I did, and then lock it back into place. Now it's a very slight tilt, and you'll be able to see it when the blade is in and everything. So once your saw is in place, most of them like the DeWalt. I don't have my DeWalt saw here, but you loosen it and the table actually tilts. So you want to have it in the right direction. We're going to be cutting in a clockwise direction, so we want the tilt to go to the outside of the plaque, like that. Okay, our saw is already in position. My saw, the head of it is tilted to the right because we want an outside bevel cut so the inside of our frame sets in. I drilled an entry hole. I didn't go quite on the X that I have on my pattern because I wanted to show you. I drilled my entry hole. You make as small a hole as possible because you really don't want it to show when you're done. And I go a little bit to the left, to the inside of the line. In this case, it was to the left. And that way, when the plaque drops down, you're not going to see the hole as much. If it were on the outside of the line, you'd see a groove in this wall. So thread the blade through. Make sure it's tight, which I missed. And now we're just going to cut in a clockwise direction like we normally cut. Number 5 reverse teeth blade, and when cutting circles and ovals, I want to mention, when cutting circles and ovals, you tend to want to look maybe a little bit in front of where you're cutting, and it helps keep your hand steady, and it keeps you in the right direction without overturning or underturning. If you're a little off, it won't matter. The important thing is if you go off the line to correct it very gradually. Don't just turn it right back into the work, or you're going to have a bump that you'll see. And steady pressure. It's almost just like you're cutting on a, you know, flat table. You can't even really tell it's beveled at this point. Going at a medium speed on the saw. when I meet up, I'm going to lean to the outside like when I started, right there. And the plaque, sometimes it gets caught, pops out, gets laid out. And you'll see the groove is right there. You could still see some on there, but it's not as deep. And the plaque will sit back and catch into itself. I don't know if you could see that edge. And it's going to frame itself. Now, as I said in the other, if you want a deeper framing, you put it at less of an angle. And if you want it to be closer to the edge, then you put it at more of an angle. And you could decide that. I always recommend that you do a test cut on a scrap. Usually on a plaque like this, you'll have the corners. And even if you did just a little circle freehanded to see how it looks, it'll give you an idea of how deep your edge is going to be. And at this point, you could route your edge here. You could do this on this type of plaque. There's plenty of room. So I prefer to do it before I do all the inside cuts. But on this one, you can certainly do it after. And if you're just doing a round over, it would probably hold up too. But it's best to do the routing before you do the scroll work, because if anything goes wrong, you don't have all that time invested in the scroll work. So that's what a self-framing plaque is, and on to cutting on the inside. Next lesson. Thank you.